Anthony.
Well, hey, you know, we're in the month of, you know, well, it is a month. We're in the month of October. October is a very important month in the annals of, you know, South African history. Well, to me it is, only because this is like a journalism month. Well, not month, it was a journalism day, international journalism. Well, those kind of days that the journalists always have, you know. And it started like back in 76 or 70, whenever they killed Steve Biko, the next year they banned all the papers and the journalists, you know, the World and a bunch of other newspapers, you know, that were, I don't want to say catering to black people, but gave the autochthonous people, you know, the Africans, as they say, it gave them a different mentality from reading the papers, because that's why newspapers and journalism is so important. Because, you know, you are what you surround yourself with, you know, what you take in. What's the computer language they used to use? Garbage in, garbage out. Mm-hmm. So if they give you garbage going in, you're going to get, you know, it's going to be in your brain and all that mm-hmm. stuff. But, you know, to tell you the truth, I'm in media. I say media. But I have done journalism. Like for instance, one of my, I had two internships when I was a young man. I like to say it that way. One was in radio, writing copy for the adverts. I wasn't very good at it. In fact, tell you the truth, I was very bad at it. But then later on, when I, you know, went got back to New York and doing radio, when I did, you know, adverts for my own programs and stuff like that, I was very good. And I said, what's the difference? Different was, I had to do it for money back then. With the other thing, I'm just aversion to aversion to like material kind of things. So I can't do that. Another time, I had an internship back when I was a young man at a radio, at a, not radio, that was a radio station, at a newspaper station, Trenton, New Jersey. And I wasn't very good at it. I mean, you know, intern, I don't know if it was really good. But when I was traveling, I was in Delray Beach, Florida for a while, about 6 months or whatever, and I was writing for the local paper, a column, an opinion column. I was very good. Ain't that interesting? You get better as you go along. But see, the thing about journalism, but especially journalists these days, you know, they got to protect themselves because, you know, the people always coming after them. They want to get their sources, which doesn't make any sense. It's a source. You can't be getting somebody's source else today. Well, anyway, you know what I mean. But the journalism today, you know, we talked about it, is sort of iffy, you know. But one of the things I learned from journalism, I learned from a comedian, Dick Gregory. Back when the Watergate things were happening, when I was doing internship, I had a news reporting and writing class, and we were covering the Watergate trial, and I think it was a Friday or something like that. This guy John Dean got on the stand. It was having hearings, and he was talking about how he was they were taping all the phone calls. Now what happened was, John Dean, when he got on there, he just told everything. And Dick Gregory said, see, now he knows what he's doing. Tell it all. That's your only protection. You got to tell it all. You can't keep no secrets. Tell it all. And that's what journalism is supposed to be. If you want a society that's going to be informed, whatever have you, you as a journalist, you got to get, and you have to tell it all. If you're a whistleblower, you know, because something happened in some agencies, you got to tell it all. That's your only protection. Because once you tell it all, they can't do nothing to you. You know, I guess you have the backup plans or whatever have you. But that's the whole thing. What I got out of journalism, you tell it all. You know, and I haven't had, well, that's it. That's all I wanted to say about that journalism. But here's the real reason why I don't do that kind of reporting. When I was in 1988, there was the presidential Democratic National Party, you know, presidential thingy. And at that time, Dukakis was the one that won the nomination over Jesse Jackson and a bunch of other people, I suppose. And I had to do what's called some vox pop. Yeah, that's voices of the people kind of thing. You go out and get interviews with people, and then you string them together, tells a little story, narrative story without your voice being in there. And I'll tell you the truth, they didn't know who I was when I got there. Anyway, I got very good at it. I mean, I was very good at it. But then last night, when I filed my last report, I had to leave. I had to run back to New York. This was happening in Atlanta. And so I put my Fox doctor, And one of the things, a little section, I had the guy do it in Spanish. Just, I don't know why I did that. I didn't know if I had to do it in Spanish. Okay. So I'm riding in the car listening. And they cut that Spanish thing out. I was upset. I'm in the driving in the car. I was upset. You know, hey. I'll give them an earful when I get back to New York. I call them, this before cell phones. I call them up and say, hey, what's going on? You cut my report. Turns out, later on in that evening, the caucus delivered a whole paragraph in Spanish. So I sort of signaled that, you know, this was a hip thing to do. And they cut out that thing. That's why I'm upset at journalism, because you have editors that take stuff away. They mess up your work. I don't like that. That's why I'm an audio dramatist. I don't edit stuff. We agree and we just go with it. That's kind of thing. Anyway, I just thought I'd record that because it's on Journalism Month, you know, and journalists all over the world is under fire and blah, 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 blah. Anyway, this is a dispatch from ArtsDirector Emeritus. That would be me, T, for the Patterson taking the train to the bed. Let you know what I only suspect.